great. I want to say thank you for coming out to show your love and prayers and condolences to my brother Joel. I mean, for the past 25 years, I've been talking about the ills in the society. And I've been insulted, I've been abused, I've been called names that I'm a very stupid person who doesn't know what he wants. However,
one house, please.
Very
thank
obvious
you.
That most of them don't really know what they want. Okay, so listen, if you're in this world and you have the opportunity to have good health and to be happy or sad, but you're in this world, just know that you're here for a reason. And your reason is to be able to add value to the lives of the person next to you as much as possible as you can. If you are not doing that, just know that you are living a stupid life. Just know that you're just a very selfish person, or you are ignorant of yourself, or you don't want to learn, or you don't truly know the reason why you're here.
Tell them.
So, Joel, please accept my condolences. It's so sad you lost your dad. I mean, for the first time, I didn't even know that your dad and you grew up in Kaduna. I was always thinking that you grew up in Kano, just like I. Eedris grew up in Kano. So, anyways, sorry you lost your dad. But I've never seen you sing a song about the ills in the society in your life before. I've never seen you talk about the problems in the country before. I've never seen you all of these. Thank you. We are not here to argue about each other, please. Everybody should just keep quiet and learn. Life is a beautiful thing. But if you cannot use your power, your business, your platform, everything that you have, that God has given you, that has blessed you, that makes you feel like a billionaire or a millionaire or a star or a superstar or whatever you think you are, if you are not using it to add value to the next person, it will come back to you. I'm not talking to Joel, I'm talking to everybody.
For
real. It will come back to you. Listen, man, I'm hurt, I'm pained, I'm not happy, I'm emotional, I'm sad. I might not be crying, tears might not be dropping, but you don't know what I'm going through. I used 25 good years of my career to talk about the ills of society, and you think I'm stupid? Or you think I don't want to talk about the boobs or the breasts to make all that money? Because it's not important. It is never important. It is never important. I've been there, done that. But you get to some age, eh? You will realize, why not start a day? To use my voice to count, or use my platform and my business to add value. Because now that value, now if fella begin, still a chop. Now if Femi Kuti, still a chop. Now if Shion Kuti, still a chop. Everything that I'm doing it for my children. And I'm training them to know what it is. It's not about me. And they are learning, they are watching, they are saying it. They are gorillas. They are what? Gorillas. They will bite you.
I want to say they go chop.
But I know they will bite me. Why Jeba? It's a crazy, it's a gangster war. There is war in Nigeria. Don't pretend. That is the problem of all of you. That's the problem of all of us. I am speaking. Have you spoken? Have you using your platform to add value to the lives of people? Is it all about money? If it was all about money, Eedris would be seen praising a lot of politicians that are my friends. But among all those politicians, I know who is my friend and I know who is my enemies. And that does not make me not to go to the studio and sing against that person whether he likes it or not. President Muhammadu Buhari, for 6 years you have not done anything. You have failed Nigeria. Officially, I've told you before, I'm not shy to say it, and I'm saying that you have failed Nigeria. Presidency is not about competition. Do you have the capacity to rule? It is not about insult. Do you have the capacity to rule? Governor Rufai, I visited you 2 times. I talked to you about the peace in Kaduna State. I talked to you about the awareness, the things that you need to do. When I came to Kaduna, through your art and culture, but you overlooked it like it was not important. He's eating you now. How do you feel? Tomorrow now, you'll come up, you say you want to be the president of this country. What's going on? Kaduna is your state. Do you feel happy that there's no peace in your state? How does it make you feel? Like it's about competition or it's about the rumor that, okay, the Fulani thing has been on before 2015 because it was good luck, Jonathan. All of a sudden, if good luck says, you know what will happen, what will start at me, then the Fulani will enter town. No. Those were rumors, right? From rumor, they say there's no smoke without fire. Please. We don't get dual citizenship. All of them get dual citizenship. If we get start now, we go run. Guy, they say you be lazy youth. Election time, they go use you. Let there be peace in Nigeria. Nigeria is for all of us. Use your platform to speak. If you don't, I don't respect you and nothing. You are just an ant. From Burna Boy to Davido, all of you I had a talk to. Because the food when they chop, no be una mama and papa cook. The people when cook and they sit down here so. So all of a sudden I can't feel like superstar. Grace worry you now. Madness and stupidity worry you now. Some of now they go to follow when I talk, when I go to stand up, when papa go sit down, or your great grand papa go sit down for interview with white man, we come to get check you. You stand up, disrespect your papa because you don't live in America. Oh shit, you hear open. Now they mad. Say that not to use our voice to speak about the ills in the society, and you are making money from the multinationals in this country. You all are fake. You're making money in this country, but you can't use your voice to speak against the ills in the society. It's coming to you. Go write it down. It's called lucky for the winner, and put lucky for the loser. It's coming to you.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we can do better. We can do better. Give it up for the legendary Mr. Bukhari.